So the one that I chose and thus had to remember which of six she was Anne Boleyn. Yeah. You know, looking back on it, everyone says, well, you should have known, Anne. You should have known, okay? It doesn't go married, lived happily ever after, died. It goes married, beheaded, died. But what people sometimes forget is, I didn't have that schooling when I grew up. Henry VIII was still just Prince Hal, and he was quite the dashing figure. Oh, we all see the pictures now with his huge codpiece and even larger gut. But when I knew Henry, he was a much kinder, gentler, sexier man. One you might see on an HBO miniseries. Those piercing eyes, that accent, and, you know, the kingdom that came with it. I should have seen it coming. I mean, any man who is married to a princess of Spain and decides, eh, not good enough for me, I probably should have gone, maybe I might not fill that space all the time. But still, I had hope. I had ambition. I had to outdo my sister. And so I married, and I married well. And I feel like I performed all of my functions well. All right, so I might not have had an heir, but, I mean, let's face it, the guy had five other wives, and he only had one male heir from any of them. I don't think it was me. And I don't want to say that Henry wasn't, you know, a great performer in the bedroom, but, I mean, history just sort of tells it out. I tried to give him some tips and advice, and what happened? Off with it. And so, ladies, I'm here to tell you this. As I lay here in the ground, about a foot, or in my case, a head shorter, remember that though you may be dancing and handsome and a king, he will leave you for the next trial. Marry a pastor instead.